Hi there, this is Unmesh from PiXimperfect, and if you're working as a team in Photoshop, then no tool can be a blessing. So let's say you have this image and you want to send it for cleaning up or maybe retouching, or maybe you want to use this as a graphic element in one of the brochures, and you want to send it to your team, and you want to say to your team, okay, do this, do that. Well, if you just say it or if you just type it, it's going to be difficult, but with the note tool, it's going to be very easy for you to do. Let me show that to you. So here's the image, and let's say you are the king, and you are sending it to me, Unmesh, to like edit the image, right? So you would do this. So here's the note tool. In the eyedropper tool group, just click and hold, and you will see the note tool. Just click on the note tool. If you still cannot see it, maybe it's hidden. You might have to click here and go to edit toolbar and maybe add the note tool right there on the left hand side. All right, I'm going to hit cancel because it's already on for me. Now, once you select the note tool, let's say you're the king and your color is red. So let's choose not red. Maybe your color is blue. Blue is nice. Just hit OK. And then maybe you're the author, so you're the king. So you want to have a faded effect right here in the shadows. So you would have to click here and you will say, I want a faded effect, right? Maybe you want warmer tones in the highlights. You would click here and you would type in warmer tones. Maybe you want a vignette effect. Let's just zoom out. And here you might say you need a vignette. And in the shadows, you would need a cyanish tint. I don't know whether that's a word, but that's okay. Now, once you save it as a PSD and once you send it, you will see all these notes. Now, once you send it to me, what I'll do is I'll do whatever you said to me. So I'll create a curves adjustment layer, maybe add warmer tones to the highlights. So let's say we just go to the red channel and add reds to the highlights and take away reds from the shadows. That will add cyan to the shadows. So I do all that and that's all cool. Maybe let's add some yellow to the highlights. So let's go to the blue channel, and yellow is the opposite of blue, right? So let's decrease the blue in the highlights and increase the blue in the shadows, just like so. You wanted a faded effect, right? So let's go to the RGB channel. Let's bring the shadows up just a little bit and bring the highlights a little down like that. That's cool. That looks nice. And I tried, let's say I tried adding a vignette and I did not like it. So I'm going to do this. Once I have done my work and I'm sending you back the PSD file, I can add my own notes. So I'm going to type in the author, Unmesh, and let's say I'm going to choose a color green, and I'm going to type here, create a note, done. Create a note, done with a yellow tint. All right, I'm creating a note here and this is done. Accidentally, I changed the color of this one. It should have been blue. So let's change it to blue. All right. So it's a great way to work in a team where you just know what work was done, what work was not done, what work needs to be done. And it's a great way to just communicate. I hope this video helped you in some way or the other. If you're working as a team in Photoshop, this will be helpful. And if this was helpful, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe. Ring the bell so that you don't miss any other future tip, trick, or tutorial. Thank you so much for all your support. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.